Hello, today I'd like to explain regarding the Sika TP Solid dry block calibrators. I'd like to explain something regarding the controller settings. As you can see, we have an industrial controller implemented, but this controller has very powerful functionality. I like to explain how to set the set point. I like to explain something about the hour counter. Then I like to explain something about the output power indication. And I like to show the content of the main menu. Okay, let's start. I like to switch on the calibrator, power on. In the upper line, in the red line, you see test. This is an indication for the initialization. In the green line, you see the current release number of the controller. After a while, the calibrator switches back to the standard indication. On the upper line, you see the current temperature value of the block. In the lower line, you see the current adjusted set point. So the set point is 40.0 degrees Celsius and the current temperature of the block is 40.00 centigrade. You can see we have a decimal point and two digits after the decimal point. This is a clear indication that we have a TP Solid calibrator in front of us. So the first thing I like to show is the set point setting. To activate a new set point, you push for a short time the P button, and then SP1 will appear, and the current value, the current set point is 40. And if you like to change the set point, you can use the upper key to increase the value. No? Or you can use the down key to decrease the value. So let's point for let's for example program 60 centigrade. Push and hold the down key. And you come to 60. Program 60 and confirm by P, and now the calibrator starts to heat up to 60 centigrade. Current temperature is 40 and now it heats up, and the heating is indicated by this small LED. So that means the temperature now will increase until we reach 60 centigrade. So some other functionalities. For example, the hour counter. If you like to know the total operating hours, you have to push the down key. And then a 13 will appear. That means this calibrator works since 13 hours. So the lifetime of the calibrator is 13 hours. This is a total hour counter. Another functionality, if you push the up key during the standard indication, then you can see H00. So this value H00 gives an indication of the current output power. Yeah. So here we see 00, that means 0% output power, because the set point is 60 and the current block temperature is 70. So that means we have to switch off the power that the calibrator cools down. And even then, the cooling down is indicated by the second LED. So that means now the calibrator cools automatically down until we reach 60 centigrade. The next one I like to explain is the main menu. If you push and hold the P button, we come to the main menu. as you can see, we have, for example, a different content in the main menu. We can see conf, we can see off, we can see oblong, we can see rec, and we can see oper. Conf is the short form of configuration. So that means if you like to go deeper in the setting of the parameters of the dry block calibrator, then you have access via these configuration menu. Off means you can switch off the automatic control. I like to show this. So you can select off in the main menu, confirm by P, and then you will see off in the standard indication alternating by the current block temperature. So that means the output is switched off, the automatic control is switched off. Now the question appears, how to activate again the automatic control of the dry block calibrator. Of course, you have to select the parameter in the main menu, and this parameter is REG, REC. That means you activate again the automatic control of the dry block. So you select in the main menu REC, confirm by P, and then automatically the automatic control of the dry block is activated again. Some other content. Push and hold the P button. We see OPLO. OPLO is a short form for operator level output. So that means the operator can set the level of the output power. If I select in the main menu this OPLO, and if I confirm by P, then in the standard display we will see in the upper line the current value of the dry block and H00. And now you can use the up key to give a percentage to the output. For example, now the calibrator will heat with 64% output power. If you like to reduce this value, you can reduce the value, the output power. So that means the operator has the possibility to set the output power level by hand. Again, the question appears, how to come back to the automatic control? Yeah, of course, you have to select in the main menu the parameter REC, confirm, and then the automatic control of the dry block calibrator is again activated. Last but not least, we have the next content of the main menu. It's OPER. This is an operator menu. The operator menu has a different content. So we see, for example, SP for set point. We see ENP for input, and we see REG for regulation. In the set point group, yeah, it's indicated by this. We see set point group. We go into the set point group by the P button, and in the set point group we can select different parameters, because we have the possibility to program up to 4 set points in the calibrator by the operator. If you like to go back, you have to wait 15 seconds or push and hold the up key, and then you come back to the set point group. If you go to the input group, go into the input group by pushing P, you see unit, a parameter called unit. And if you like to go into the parameter, you push P, and then you see the unit is centigrade. And now you can switch over, for example, from centigrade to Fahrenheit, to centigrade to Fahrenheit. So that means you can select the engineering unit. In our case, it's centigrade. I select the value, confirm the value. I'm back on the parameter. Push and hold the up key. I'm on the group in the operator menu. And last but not least, I like to show some contents of the group REG. This is regarding the control. Here we can also find different parameters. Slower, that means this parameter is for slow rising. That means we can program a ramp in the dry block calibrator. Then, of course, we have a duration time. If we increase the temperature and if we like to hold the temperature, then we have a duration time. We can program a duration time. And last but not least, we see sloth. That means it's a slow level down. That means we increase the temperature by a certain gradient. So really, you can program a ramp. That means rising temperature, centigrade per minute, a duration time if you reach a set point, and then you can cool down the calibrator by a certain gradient to program a ramp. And now, as we do not operate any operating key, the calibrator comes back automatically after approximately 15 seconds to the group, from the parameters to the group, and then it takes again 15 seconds to go back to the standard indication. So as you see, I did not operate any operating keys, and if you do not operate any operating keys, you have to wait, and then the calibrator comes back to the standard basis display. Yeah, that's what to explain regarding the TP solid line. Thanks for your attention.